make sure it fits flush. Again, all I'm using to flare these is a bolt and a nut that fits the rib nut. Right into the body. Work away right around. Now, like I said, I bought that stupid rib nut gun and it broke before I even got to even set my first rib nut. Almost there. At first I was lightly tapping them in with the hammer, but it's not worth the risk of putting a dent in it, truthfully. Might as well just take the time and drill it until it fits. So you don't want to go a size bigger. You want to keep it right at a quarter. And then just kind of waller it out slowly. Hold this one tight, tighten the bottom one. Now the rib nut set. Thank you. notice we removed the antenna here. We'll patch that up. I had to make a makeshift patch, which isn't very good. As you can see, I can push down on it. Oh well. We'll fix it up later.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, that could have been bad. About jerked my drawers off. Make sure the drill stops spinning before you put it beside your jogger. Got me so messed up I forgot my rib nut. That sucker's almost set, just shoving it in there.
Yeah.
That was perfectly drilled. I wish I could do that every time. So if your rib nut gun breaks the little end piece that you need, have no fear. Just find you a bolt and a nut that'll fit in that rib nut and you're good to go. You can finish your project at 3 in the morning when all closed stores are closed. It's not 3 in the morning here yet, but I'm just saying, if it were, we could still get the job done with a nut and a bolt that fits the rib nut. Can't get it to come, get the bolt to come out, grab both wrenches, turn the same way. Gives you extra leverage, it should come right out. Now, this is the way to go as far as I'm concerned for a body kit. You don't want to drill sheet metal screws into the body and then it just keeps getting more and more worn out, more and more worn out. These rib nuts, you can take one of the body kit, put off the body kit. You can put on different body kits and you already have threaded holes ready to go, you know? This part will always run a body kit from this point forward, so it is what it is. Getting there.
Did you show him the puppy? Is he the puppy?
Oh, he just took off. The dog stole the show.
Oh, look at him. Man, he's so young.
Doggy's stealing my show?
He's so cute.
Probably be better. He'd probably get more views.
Yeah.
I guarantee that. For sure. I don't think you can consider yourself a real shop unless you got an Australian Blue Heeler at this point. I mean, how many shop guys out there have Australian Blue Heelers?
Yeah.
Like, what can I say? Car guys, cattle guys, it's all the same. I did it again. I almost wrapped myself up. I'm going to catch myself on the... One of these days, and I'm going to be regretting it.
Yeah.
Ow. Sometimes when you're in little tight spaces like this, it's a lot more difficult. and you really wish you had a working rib nut gun. I wish I wouldn't have broke mine. It's probably my fault. I definitely pushed it very hard, thinking I had to, and I probably didn't even have to. It was probably a good set, my dumb ass, thinking I had to make sure it closed all the way. Made sure it closed all the way, all right, and snapped the end right off of it. So now I'm back to the old-fashioned way, flaring rib nuts. If there ever was an old-fashioned way, not for sure how long rib nuts have been around. I guess as long as me, if not longer. I learned my lesson though, when it starts to get out to here and it still hasn't cleared yet, stop what you're doing. Back the nut back up. Tighten it all the way back down. Get too much space, you're going to bind it and you're going to strip the threads. I learned that quick. So you want to have it real tight starting point. Do to deal with that. Get a little bit of grease. What's happening is it's grabbing a hold of it and wants to spin it. Put a little bit of that on. Instead of spinning the whole rib nut, there you will only be spinning. Well, whole rib nut. Had to grab it by a pair of pliers and start a new one.